Hello friends, in the series of control chart creation, I am going to explain Xbar-R chart in this video. An Xbar-R chart plots the process mean, that is Xbar chart, and process range, that is R chart, over the period of time for variable data in subgroup. This combination control chart is widely used to examine the stability of processes in many industries. So let's begin the learning of Xbar-R chart. Xbar-R chart, that is Xbar and range chart. Xbar-R chart is used when data is continuous and collected in subgroup. To use Xbar-R chart, subgroup size must be 8 or less than 8. If it is more than 8, we have to use Xbar-S chart. We will see Xbar-S chart at the end of this video. We can use Xbar-R chart to monitor the process mean and variation for subgroups of part lengths, call times, or hospital patients' blood pressure over time, etc., etc. Like all control charts, Xbar-R chart also has three main uses. 1. Monitoring the stability of a process. Even very stable processes have some variation, and when try to fix minor fluctuations in a process, you can actually cause instability. 2. Determining whether a process is stable and ready to be improved. When you change an unstable process, you can't accurately assess the effect of the changes. An Xbar-R chart can confirm or deny the stability of your process before you implement a change. 3. Demonstrating improved process performance. This is needed to show that a process has been improved or not. Before and after Xbar-R chart can provide that proof. The Xbar chart and the R chart are displayed together because you should interpret both charts to determine whether your process is stable. Examine the R chart first, because the process variation must be in control to correctly interpret the Xbar chart. The control limits of the Xbar chart are calculated considering both process spread and the center. If the R chart is out of control, then the control limits on the Xbar chart may be inaccurate and may falsely indicate an out of control condition or fail to detect one. Creating the Xbar-R chart. A company wants to monitor the runout of wall seat inserts on assembly used in cylinder heads. Data is collected at every 30 minutes with the subgroup size of 3. This wall seat insert has an upper tolerance of 0.08 mm, that is 80 microns. Data in micron is shown in the table below. Data is collected for 25 numbers of subgroup. To create the Xbar-R chart, go to the Minitab menu and select Stat, Control Chart, Variable Chart for Subgroup, and then Xbar-R. Select an option of Observation for subgroup are in one row of column. Select X1 to X3 and click on the Xbar-R options. Once Xbar-R chart window open, select Perform all tests for special causes and click OK. You will get the final result of Xbar-R chart as below. Interpreting the Xbar-R chart. Part 1. Look at the R chart first, because if the R chart shows that the process variation is not in control, then the control limits on the Xbar chart are inaccurate. The R chart in the above example shows that the process variation is in control. No points are out of control, and all the points fall within the control limit in a random pattern, having lower control limit as 0 and the upper control limit as 57.77. Part 2. Now, we can look at Xbar chart to assess whether the process center is in control. Minitab conducts up to 8 special cause variation tests for the Xbar chart and marks problem observations with a red symbol and the number of failed tests. The graph tells you one observation that failed test. The Minitab session window tells you why each point was flat. Observation number 22, failed test 1, which tests for points more than 3 standard deviations from the center line. The strongest evidence that a process is out of control. Again, observation number 22 also had failed test 5, which tests for 2 out of 3 points that fall more than 2 standard deviations from the center line. Test 5 provides additional sensitivity for detecting smaller shifts in the process mean. This Xbar-R chart indicates that the process average is unstable and the process is out of control, possibly due to the presence of special causes. Now let's see Xbar-S chart, that is Xbar and Standard Deviation Chart. The entire procedure for Xbar-R chart is similar to Xbar-R chart except few points. Let me explain them so that both the charts along with their similarities and differences will be clear to us. Both charts are used when the data is continuous and data collected in subgroup. But if subgroup size is 8 or less than 8, we have to use Xbar-R chart. And if it is more than 8, we have to use Xbar-R chart. In creation of Xbar-R chart, the procedure is similar to the Xbar-R chart, except you have to use option of Xbar-R chart instead of Xbar-R chart. Interpreting Xbar-R chart, that is Xbar and Standard Deviation chart. In interpretation, like R chart in the Xbar-R chart, we have to look at S chart, that is Standard Deviation, first to see whether the process variation is in control. And if process variation is in control, then we can look at the Xbar chart as same is in the Xbar-R chart. This is all about Xbar-R and Xbar-R chart. With these charts, we have learned control charts for the variable data. If you have to learn control chart and its analysis, Minitab software is really one of the things you must have. I will explain the control charts for attribute data with example in the next video. Please like the videos on my channel if you found them meaningful, and keep adding comments so that I can serve you in a better way. You can also suggest which topic you want to see in my next video. I will use that information to make this forum more interactive. I am also thankful to my friends with whom I am having a longer discussions regarding concepts and questions. I really liked it. Share these videos with all your friends and families who need it and subscribe my channel. Click on the bell icon after subscription to get the notifications of new videos on my channel. I will continue to share similar useful information which will help you to improve your knowledge and skills regarding continuous improvements. And finally, thank you for watching.